get your yearbooks, embrace the Kennedy High spirit, and cling to the memories of the beautiful people. You owe me 20 more bucks or I'm gonna rip those braids right out of your scalp.
Nick, speaking of memories, I'm getting nostalgic. I just can't believe it's the last day of our sophomore year. You know, I might cry.
I love the merry month of May. The only thing I don't like about it are those ridiculous sweep cliffhanger stunts that they always pull on my favorite teen dramas. You know, where there's always a wedding or somebody gets pregnant or somebody dies.
Or there's a terrifying natural disaster or an appearance by a cheesy boy band or exploitative nudie shots of pretty boy asses.
Or how about those horrific When Pets Attack stunts or those hideous, gratuitous musical numbers? I prefer reality when one can just bask in the thrill of sophomore skip day and say goodbye to dear friends.
Or enemies.
This is an outrage and I want my money back. This is not a yearbook, it's a Glamazon scrapbook. You bitches only included candid photos of yourselves in this thing.
Well, Lily, if you would stop trembling like a death row pound pooch and turn to page 47, you would see that we actually did include you.
You know what? Maybe you should skip sophomore skip day and go get that lazy eye fixed, huh?
Woo! Break, break, break! Okay, there is not a shot of you in this thing, so why are you grinning like an idiot?
Just saying silent praise to Yahweh. This is a year I would rather forget. But I've come to a realization. Life is about two things. Endings and beginnings, deaths and births.
Births? What do you mean, births?
The end of school, tomorrow's long-dreaded wedding. I decided I could look at both as doors closing or as windows opening to new opportunities. I've decided to accentuate the positive, that's all.
Dearest Harrison, rotten hell, you zit-faced homo. Love, Nicole.
Nicole, hope you cure all your STDs over the summer. Whore, love, Harrison.
No fun and frivolous yearbook signing in my class. Until that is, I can have a crack at a tome poem. May I? And, Mr. John, will you sign my book?
Say something. We have 1 minute left in this class, and we need to get our final grades so we can skip off to skip day at Magic Mountain.
Right. Miss Glass, sir, could we get our final grades now?
Oh, certainly. Miss McQueen, of course you get an A+. As for the rest of you, D's all around.
What?
That is not fair, Miss Glass. You can't give us a grade without handing back our final test.
I didn't grade your tests. I was too busy cursing your individual images as they appeared to me in a fever dream. You see, Generation Why Me? You have been my most disobedient, unfocused class ever. Because canings are allowed in Singapore and not here in the good old US of A, I've decided nonetheless to smack your butts, Glass style.
Miss Glass, why aren't any of our pictures in your yearbook?
Thanks for asking, Harrison. I've cut out your faces and made a composite ID sheet, which I've sent to the head of security at Magic Mountain. If any of you skip school today and show up there, you'll be immediately arrested for truancy.
So what, you fossil hag? There's 150 other restaurants and hangouts we could skip off to.
According to my Zagat's Guide 155, all of these places, along with the LAPD, have also been faxed your pinched little faces. In short, you skip school today anywhere in this city, and you will be arrested and, accordingly, be held back a grade. Have a great summer!
Somebody ought to kill that Miss Glass.
For once, Mary Cherry, I agree with you.
Think it over once or twice. What lasts the longest in this life? Character or rock hard advice? In the end, do you believe that beauty lies in what you see? 'Cause if you do, then baby, you've been deceived. Well, me.
can't believe we got skip day privileges pulled. Man, Bobby Glass sucks. Yo, Scrub, what's wrong? You look all white. What'd you see, Bioglass naked or something?
Shh. Sugar, I think that just might be my fate. I think she desires me. Check out what she wrote in my yearbook. I am freaked.
Dear Harrison, the sight of you makes my thighs sweaty. Ugh. I can't hold you back a year, but next year I can and will hold you in my tender sexual embrace. Enjoy your summer. Love, Bioglass.
Harrison. Oh. I'd like my pen back.
Is that what I see hiding under that filmy, sexy tea towel?
Holy mother of God, you're a goner!
I am so ashamed. Put the groove
in the shoes. Hey, Shug. Yo, what up, baby?
I need your advice. Look, being the last day of school and all.
Yeah.
Well, I really think I've grown up this year, but something's incomplete.
Your boo, Brooke?
Yeah. I mean, I really miss her, Shug. I want to bring life back to a dead romance, you know? Do you have any ideas that might, I don't know, win her back?
Look at Bioglass and Harrison. They prove that courtship begins not between the sheets, but between the pages of a yearbook.
Really?
Yeah, a woman looks at what you write at the year end, and it's a culmination of your feelings. You write a good yearbook inscription to boo? Man, she's gonna sleep with you as fast as her parents go on a honeymoon. I'll guarantee it! Yeah!
Side. If Miss Glass hadn't pulled the skip day rug out from under you, you would have had time to come up with such a good menu for the rehearsal dinner tonight.
Oh, thanks, Brooke.
Let's make a pact. We make this dinner a perfect night to remember, with no glitches and no problems. A perfect launch for their new life together.
Hi, Brooke.
Oh, hey. What's up?
I was wondering, I would love to sign your yearbook. Can I have it and return it when I'm done? I want what I write to be, you know, right.
Okay, sure. I mean, we have been through a lot this year.
Thanks.
Shut up.
You guys are hilarious. You're like one of those typical TV show couples that breaks up, gets back together, breaks up, then gets back together one last time on the last show, strictly for promotional sweeps purposes.
I know.
Then what happened when you ruined their skip day and turned them into laughing stocks?
I told them to have a great summer. You should have seen the look on their faces. Oh.
This. We're the only people left in the whole school. That hideous Miss Glass has ruined all our skip day fun. We're laughing stocks. You just know she's sitting somewhere right now reveling in our torment.
Is that Aramis you're wearing, Vice Principal Calvin Krupps?
Oh, no. That's my natural body mask.
Can I pour you a glass of Remy Martin before we do our morning announcements?
But it's noon, Miss Glass.
There's 10 kids left in this friggin' school. You're principal now, stud. They're on your time.
Yes. Hit it.
Good morning, Kennedy High students. This is your acting principal, Calvin Krupps. And I am happy to say, bon voyage. Oh, what a year it has been. A year of both traumatic lows and awe-inspiring highs. Looking back, we've seen it all, haven't we, kids? We sat by and watched as two of our girls from different walks of life put their petty differences aside and learned at long last to be sisters. Their journey was so drawn out and laborious that many of us wondered, hey, what about my story? When am I getting some screen time? As we move on, the beginnings that await us will hopefully prove to be exciting. Maybe some of us will dabble with bisexuality, like our gay parents have. Maybe one of us will learn it's what's inside that matters, and maybe over the summer that person will date and cherish exquisite woo. Maybe one of us will get back with our golden girl girlfriend, despite dark flirtatious thoughts of quitting school and becoming a porn star. And maybe one of us will grow up to become a hustler centerfold or an axe murderer. Needless to say, kids, the future is yours. Think of this last day of school as a fresh start. Just whatever you do, don't bring a bastard child into this world. On a final note, please remember to pray for May Tuna, who, thanks to a bacterial infection brought on by dirt eating, now suffers a faulty heart valve and is actively looking for a heart donor. Godspeed, May, and Godspeed everyone here at Kennedy High.
Retribution would be a bore. Bobby Glass has really got some gore. A little prank would truly hit the spot, and I'm sure that it would mean a lot to all of us here to drink some payback juice. Bobby Glass is a skank who deserves a prank, a little teasing, 'cause she stood in our way. All year long she's really hit us low, causing suffering for all and Joe. And I think it's quite clear, it's our turn to play a dangerous liaison to settle the score.
Tomorrow, a fresh beginning. We cannot risk a plot. Besides, these things never work with any aplomb. Case in point, teaching Mrs. Tingle a huge stinking bomb.
I agree with Fair Brookie. Time for peace here, time for light. And I know if the prank goes awry, I'll be blamed. People already think I'm a psycho untamed.
Don't be quitters, you make me sick.
I for one would agree with Nick.
There's no need for alarm, we'll cause no real harm.
We give her a case of diarrhea.
You keep vials of E. coli poisoning in your purse?
A girl never knows when she'll need to lose the odd 50 pounds.
Eye for an eyeball, a prank for a skank named Miss Glass. An eye for an eyeball, a scheme for the bitter. E. coli would knock her on her ass.
All these kids with their privilege and clear skin, they make me quite sick. I barely make minimum wage, and I've never been licked. But I've got dreams and I'm ruthless. My vengeance isn't toothless. They all get D's and no sophomore skip day. Aha!
And I for an
then again, I got an A all year long, Miss Glass's pet. To give her E. coli could jeopardize that.
Then the wedding, peace and quiet, how I've earned it, how I yearn for no disasters, no hardships, just quiet grace.
this is how we're gonna get it. Joe will simply distract the beast from her lunchtime shake munching and be done with it.
Don't give up, we need to be united. Please help me from being Bobby Glass's defenseless sexual plaything.
Count us in, but we can't be very long. We have to go grocery shopping.
Miss Glass. We have a present for you.
What do you kids take me for, huh? A sucker?
You think you're being clever here, don't you?
Original, think again. Every year, one of my classes presents me with a gag shake. Last year, third period gifted me with my fave banana smoothie, literally crawling with the Ebola virus. But I'm too smart for that. I knew you were coming. That's why I took the liberty of changing in advance your grades to solid Fs.
What? Miss Glass, if you flunk us, we'll have to repeat sophomore year.
Yes, and you'll have me for 9 solid months of hell.
Sign that. Anybody want me?
Get one thing straight. Nothing can stop or kill me. After a nuclear apocalypse, I'll be the only thing left standing, other than the cockroaches and Cher.
What can I write to make Brooke fall hopelessly in love with me again? Dear Brooke. Dear Brooke.
She's dead.
How can that be? She didn't even drink the shake, and even if she did, all it would have done was cause the runs, not a sprint towards death.
Okay, calm down. Now, this is fixable. I know exactly what to do. We frame Spam and have her arrested for murder.
Yes.
What? Why do I have to take the fall?
Do you guys realize what this means? It means the wedding tomorrow is going to be ruined.
Well, we could have figured Sam would have done something to screw it up.
Anybody have any pickles?
Oh, my God, you guys, look at this. Those who can't do, teach. Those who can't do, teach. Those who can't do, teach.
Maybe Miss Glass had a stroke or something. I mean, obviously, she was under a lot of stress.
The teachers are so underpaid and underappreciated in our culture. Oh, God, this must be her journal. All of her secret dreams and haiku hopes locked away like her potential. I suddenly feel horrible about this.
You should. You killed my sister.
Nurse Jessie. Sam did it.
I did not!
I think you did. All of you. Is this E. coli I smell?
Okay, yes, but she didn't drink it.
Listen, kids, I can understand why you do this. She's always been a bitch. I won't expose you if we all take a vow of silence.
But we didn't do anything!
Yes, you did! Let's just keep this little tragedy quiet. Otherwise, this little wedding I've been hearing so much about, yet haven't been invited to, won't be happening. Because you'll all be otherwise engaged. In jail.
Dear Brooke. Wait. Dear Brooke. I guess it was plotting the death of Miss Glass that made me feel so close to you again.
If we go to jail, this wedding will be canceled. That can't happen.
We did nothing, nothing, and I am not taking the fall.
We did do something. We were responsible for her stress and her resulting stroke. Damn you all to hell.
Just stick with the plan. Frame spam.
No, I have to be at the wedding.
Shut up, everybody. Sweet mother of God, shut up.
Look, I am freaked by Bobby Glass and her inappropriate carnal lust for me. But I still feel weird about her just being carted away. Now, shouldn't we at least call the hospital or the police?
We can't call the police, you moron. The LAPD already has Ms. Glass's insane ID composite sheet, okay? We already look suspicious.
Did anybody but me find it odd that Nurse Jessie accused us and then almost immediately said, watch the body while I pull the Pinto around?
Yeah. What's up with that?
FYI, kids. I wouldn't call the police or a hospital if I were you. Authorities ask a lot of questions, and I'm afraid that E. coli shake is very damaging evidence against you. Have a great summer.
Okay, it's done. Let's just have the rehearsal dinner and
tomorrow we'll have the wedding and everybody will be calm and cool and quiet about what happened, right?
Alone in a cold teacher seat. Students, my life rafts. No space for me. Sad.
What my sister thinks of me. Another haiku by Miss Bobby Glass.
Ground glass in my cereal. She wants me dead. Jealousy. Green likes not. Why do I have to share a bed with one who despises me? Sad.
Jessie killed her, and I think that she let us off scot-free only to frame us for murder later.
We need to recover the body, and we need to order up an autopsy before the evidence is destroyed, or we are gonna spend our summer vacation in juvie.
This is sick. Oh my God. What do you think Nurse Jessie's doing with the body?
In case you're wondering, this is catnip. Oh, sis of mine, I've got plans for you. Big plans.
I know you can hear me, zombie.
I can hear you. Why can't I speak?
You can't speak because I've dosed you. Dosed you with exotic herbs from New Guinea to slow your body's metabolic rate down. To the world, you're dead. But I know you're alive. You can feel everything, can't you?
Yes, particularly this pen jutting out of my throat.
I've loathed you since birth. I want a new beginning. And when I frame those kids for murder, I'll get it. The best things about killing you? Sleeping in our twin bed alone and giving my beloved pussies the best damn meal of their nine lives. Ooh.
What? I'm gonna be eaten alive?
That's right, you heard me. I've starved those cats for 2 weeks. When I return from running on the treadmill at my Linda Evans gym, I better find nothing here but bones.
Booger face! Rotten hell!
Wow!
This isn't so bad. Oh, watch the fingers, puss. Oh, no!
You know, it's funny. I feel like something happened when you were away. Like you met or talked to someone who had a big effect on you. I mean, you were so opposed to this merging of families all year long, and now suddenly you're so into it.
Nope, I didn't meet anybody. Guess I'm just growing up, that's all.
Brooke, thanks for letting me come to your rehearsal dinner. I hope I'm not in your way as you prepare for the feast.
May, I'm a little confused here.
My make dreams come true wish is very clear and simple.
As an unfortunate child, I am allowed one dream request.
And your dream come true request was to spend it with me and be involved in our family's wedding festivities?
Yes. Before my time is up, I just want to know what it's like to be popular.
Brooke! Yeah, Mary Cherry, put her finger in the fridge. Bring me Diet Coke.
No, what are you doing here?
Nurse Jessie killed her, and now she's gonna pin the dirty deed on us.
You guys, take her out of here. She's gonna ruin the rehearsal dinner, and I know I'm gonna be blamed for everything.
Mm-hmm. That sounds like a freight train.
It's the sound that happens right before.
Oh my God, y'all!
Is everybody all right? Oh my God, May. You're bleeding profusely. Jane, can you call an ambulance? I think we should get May to the hospital.
No! I want to stay here with Brooke. I want to see what it feels like to be popular.
Back off! Why is your teacher here? I thought you hated her.
We do. But I'm trying to be more positive, and I wanted to include her.
Why is she in a Hannibal Lecter gurney?
She's very tired.
You know, I'd like to make a toast. I'd like to thank Brooke and Sam for throwing this rehearsal dinner. You know, making a family is never easy. In fact, it's pretty hard. But thanks to their efforts tonight, both as a team and as individuals, a family is what we have become, all of us. A toast to Brooke and to Sam and to my beautiful wife-to-be.
Dig in, everybody. The gas is out, and we cannot reheat this food. Aren't you hungry, Miss Glass?
Miss Glass, is there a problem?
Dear God, help me. I shouldn't have had that burrito.
Yes.
There is a problem.
As you can hear from my sister's gastric rumbling, she has a terrible digestive disorder. I'm here to take her to the hospital for tests. Have a nice wedding. Enjoy the fresh air and sunshine
while you can, kids.
What a strange thing to say. I mean, it almost sounds like she's threatening you with prison.
Guys, think fast. Nurse Jessie killed Bioglass, but if we say anything, she's gonna frame us for the murder.
Wait a minute, why didn't she just frame us immediately?
Well, maybe she wanted to torture Bobby Glass first.
Wait, you can't torture a dead body.
Wait a minute, can a dead body pass gas?
Joe's right. Oh my God, I just remembered something. The pieces of the puzzle are coming together. I don't think Miss Glass is dead. I think Nurse Jessie. Well, I think she put some kind of voodoo curse on her, you know, Santeria.
Mary Cherry, that's nuts. What makes you think that?
Unless it was my imagination, I saw somebody when we were at the house moving the body who looked shockingly suspicious.
If that's true, if Santeria was invoked, then we have to get the body back before Nurse Jessie really kills her.
Yeah. Brooke, can I have a little bit more time with you, your book?
Okay, Joshy.
The body's not here.
Maybe the witch doctor knows where she took her.
Wait, how in the hell do you know Miss Glass's phone number?
We only crank color every night, wannabe.
This is fruitless.
Let's just face it, the wedding is off and we are gonna go to jail.
No, wait!
Hi, Avery
reach the Glass Sisters' residence, remember your flu shot and make sure you eat 5 helpings of fruits and veggies every day to avoid colon rectal cancer. Bobby no longer lives here. I'm at the Los Feliz Crematorium at Vermont and Franklin. Leave a message after the beep.
It's over. She's only ashes now.
Yes, but she's never been thinner.
Garbage collectors make more than teachers. Did you guys know that?
This wedding is ruined.
Maybe not. It's 9 people's word against 1. Maybe this whole thing will blow over and we won't have to spend our junior year in juvie if nobody, and I mean nobody, confesses to the madness we've seen.
Rest in peace, Miss Bobby Glass.
Beautiful flowers. Beautiful girls. Putting on shoes. Zipping up zippers. Touching up lips. All for a wedding where someone will die. Starting over, only to perish.
You guys, we look hot. Maybe our prayers will be answered and this wedding today will go smoothly.
Nurse Jessie hasn't filed charges yet. Maybe she just wanted her sister dead so she could start over.
I can't believe it. This thing actually might go off without a hitch.
Yeah, the only hitch being so far that Mary Cherry's an hour late.
Hi, Hans! Here comes the bride!
So what do we do again?
It's very simple. All you do is ask bride or groom's side and then seat the guests accordingly.
Didn't you used to work at Mr. Clock's and try and sell us into the white slavery trade?
I worked at many sinful jobs before I found God and went to the seminary. I'll screw up this wedding. It's my first. I need it to go right. I am aiming for sainthood. Got it?
Bride or groom side?
Brooke side. I want to be near Brooke. That's the make a dream come true deal.
Bride or...
Where's my sister?
We told you, we don't have your sister's body. It was burned at the crematorium.
That's a lie. I dropped her off, then went to retrieve her ashes later, and they said she had been shipped elsewhere.
Look, Lizzie Borden, we know you're behind this. We didn't take her.
Then who did?
Good news. The hospital called. They just got a donor heart.
My sister was an organ donor. She kept an organ donor card on her at all times.
Wait, where's Carmen?
I don't know. We don't have time to look for her. They're probably cutting into Bobby Glass this very minute. Come on!
You may begin, my child.
Forgive me, Father, for I have sinned. My last confession was in 86, and these are my sins. Actually, only one in particular.
Yes, my child. What is it?
I can't keep this a secret any longer. I have a confession to make.
How do I look?
Come here, let me see. Honey, you look like a billion. Can you believe we're doing this again?
Oh, second time's a charm.
Second, try 10th. I can't believe I'm marrying the Hollywood legend Eric Estrada at the ripe old age of 25. Dreams do come true. Well, let's review the stupid but necessary bridal traditions. Something old, something new.
Something borrowed, something blue.
Damn, I forgot something borrowed. Hey, could you limit your diaphragm?
Man, I haven't felt this jittery since I was on the People's Choice Awards back in 77.
Are you nervous?
Me? Honestly, yeah. The feet are definitely a bit cold.
Yeah, yeah, me too. I feel like there's an arm reaching into my guts, pulling out my internal organs one by one.
Okay, here's the liver.
Good thing she's dead. This is gonna hurt like a mother.
Kidneys. My God, this is a medical first. This person doesn't have a heart.
What?
Ever since they cut her open and sent her away? No.
Oh. Where is the doctor?
Calling Ripley's, believe it or not. Why?
Okay, great. Where's Miss Glass?
She's been taken care of. Or should I say disposed of. In less than an hour, my sister will fulfill a childhood dream of mine and be buried. Alive. And then it's real quick off to Six Flags for a little R&R, and then on with my life.
What's gonna happen to us now?
Oh, well, you'll be framed for murder and then spend your junior year in juvie.
You won't get away with this, Nurse Jessie. You don't have the proof.
Oh, I think I do, stud. Some of us should be a little more careful when signing our practice yearbooks. Dear Brooke, I guess it was plotting the death of Miss Glass that made me feel so close to you again.
How could you write that? It's not romantic.
It was my practice book, Brooke.
This isn't over. We're gonna find that body, we're gonna get the evidence we need, and then we're gonna make a scene.
Oh, I think not, Sparky. I've sent that body to a place that you wouldn't dare disrupt.
Sitting in silence for an hour. This is a church, not a yoga center. I know the Lord probably never used this phrase, but your time is up, my child.
Oh, wait, but I sinned badly.
Okay. Tell me where the body is. I'll give you 3 Hail Marys. You can be on your way, okay?
What makes you think that I killed someone?
You're a bored suburban teenager. Bored suburban teenagers listen to Metallica. You do the math.
Look, my sin is of a more personal nature. I'm sorry. God, what am I gonna tell my parents, you know?
What are you ashamed of?
I'm pregnant.
God would understand. We all mess up. Are you sure?
I have been throwing up for 2 weeks. I think I'm pregnant, and I don't know what to do.
Who's the father? Oh, sorry. Scheduling conflict. Got a boogie.
Hey.
Hey.
Okay, so I finished. I know it took me a while, but I really think it sums up what we've been through this year and our future.
Dear Brooke, see you next fall. Love, Josh.
Let's get back together, Brooke. Even if it means being pen pals after we're sent to prison for murder.
I love that.
Oh, I'm so nervous.
Hey, you look amazing. Okay, you're gonna be fine.
I love you, honey.
I love you too, Mom.
I didn't want to sleep with her, but I didn't want her to be killed off either. At least I have this inscription in my yearbook to remember her by, huh?
Buck up, geek. I wrote that.
Man.
Okay, we've got a problem. Bobby Glass's casket is parked out front.
What? If I go to jail, then my dreams of being a supermodel will be dashed! Dashed all to hell!
There is a solution. An anti-Santeria solution, to be exact.
Of
I knew that spring break trip to Mardi Gras last year would pay off. But how are we gonna get this in Bobby Glass's body?
I don't know, but we've got 1 minute to figure it out. Or someone's going to die. To take the antidote to kick in.
I have no idea.
My dear. Let me chase away your pain and your fear. Say that you'll always be right here. Will you marry me?
You may be seated. I now pronounce you husbands and wives. You may kiss your brides. I'm sorry, I'm new at this. Okay, does anybody here know why these couples should not be united in holy matrimony?
I do.
I'm sorry, is there a problem?
Actually, yes. Mike McQueen and I are not divorced.
No.
Star who